Gormley. I play Bianca Scott on Good Old Crime LA, and I'm here today to answer some questions for the lovely guys to panel crime. So I was over here for a gap year, which I worked in a pub and loved it, a proper English pub in Henley on Thames, and then sort of fell in love with the place and the people and decided to get a real job and make an air hostess for Qantas because they just opened a base. So I did that for 2 years and then went, oh, hang on, there's something I really, really wanted to do. And that was, at the time, I was acting and teaching drama. So I came back to Australia and got stuck back into it, got into wonderful drama school over there. And yeah, it's been sort of just good from there on. I really related to Bianca very, very quickly. Very tough cookie on the outside. And I knew there was something going on underneath. She was soft and sweet. I knew that. So I walked into the audition room with Axel and I went, you know what? I'm going to take this boy down a few pegs. And I did. And it was really funny. And bless him. I think he was scared. He won't admit it, but he was scared. I loved Bianca and I was very lucky that it came up 3 months out of drama school. She was sort of right place, right time. Things for an actor, like the storyline in which she was raped, very intense. It's hard to say enjoyed doing that, but as far as researching and finding out some amazing stories of pretty amazing women being through these kind of things, that was great as an actress to explore. And the Great Storm was great. It was epic. And we got to work with all kinds of stunts and some roofs falling in. And that was a great experience. It's like working on a movie. And that's a very, very full on time for Bianca. Charlie, who's obviously one of her best friends, betrays her in a way. And puts her in a position that I don't think any friend should ever put another friend in. She had to lie to the police to protect Charlie and Brax, and it doesn't bode well for Charlie and Bianca's friendship. Bianca decides to cover the truth. It does affect their relationship. She's very scared that she's having to lie to the man that she loves. She's very angry with Brax and Charlie for making her do that. But at the same time, she's sort of, stuck between a rock and a hard place, I suppose, and you can't do much in that situation. So she tries to just keep her mouth shut and hope for the best that she can dissuade him otherwise. She'd rather he hate her than know the truth. So it's lovely when those two, decide to make a go of it. And Bianca realizes, obviously, in that situation that she's very much in love with the man and decides to nurse him back to health and hopefully get their relationship together back on track. Heath, obviously, still quite hurt by this, but hey, what can you do? You love someone, you sort of tend to go that way. Yeah, poor Heath on the sidelines. Nothing ever stays a secret for long in Summer Bay, don't we know it? Thank you, Colleen. The truth does come out, and obviously Liam is very, very hurt that Bianca lied to him, especially in this sort of new relationship they've started again, and he finds out that she's lied, and it's devastating and very scary for Bianca. She thinks she's going to lose her man again. I don't know. I was talking to someone earlier, and they seem to work well in different ways. Bianca and Heath have great chemistry, and they spar with each other, which is initially what Bianca and Liam had. But I think the Liam and Bianca thing is true love. I think soulmates happening there. Whereas the thing with Heath, it's that raw chemical attraction. We'll experience that. I'd love to see Bianca sit down in the future. I'd love another wedding. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I think it'd be fun to see her sort of doing a bit of ironing and keeping her home. I don't think that would ever happen, but I think I'd like Bianca to smile more, have a bit of a laugh, not take things quite so seriously. Hang on, that that's pretty much my resolution this year, not take things so seriously. Again, I think I'd like to see some comedy. I'd like to see her falling over things and being very silly situations and seeing how she deals with them. There are wedding bells somewhere in the bay.